Big Al arriving on campus, and not just that, Nick Saban getting escorted out to Tuscaloosa, Alabama's campus to shine, and he got escorted by the state trooper, and yeah. Here they go, they make an arrive at Tuscaloosa, Alabama campus. As they go, and not just that, we got some NFL superstars, and some wide receivers from last year, and some players from last year from Alabama. They got out of the bus to talk, and we will show you the talking right after this. Here it is, right now. Check it out.
For me, you know, to be here today and be able to do this, it was such an honor playing for you guys, and you know, being in Brian Denny, man, the best 5 years of my life.
But, yeah.
Tuscaloosa always got a spot in my heart, and you know, I love you guys forever, and Roll Tide.
Thank you, Anthony. Next is a standout defensive back who always played with an attitude. He smacked guys in the mouth all season long. Among the many honors, he was named the defensive MVP of the Orange Bowl against Oklahoma, where he had 5 total tackles, 4 passes defended. He's from Roswell, Georgia. Welcome back to campus, Xavier McKinney. Roll Tide.
Roll Tide!
It's an honor to just have this here for life, just to know that I can come back here and always get to see this. You know, I was grateful to come here and play for all of you guys, for my coaches, for my teammates. And, you know, this spot in Tuscaloosa right here is forever in my heart, and I appreciate you guys. Roll Tide. Next is a rare 2-time captain here at the Capstone, and he's going to help us transition from the 2019 to the 2020 team, as he was a captain on both of those teams. His pass-catching talents are beyond compare. He set 8 school receiving records during his time here in Tuscaloosa. He was the first wide receiver to win the Heisman Trophy. He was the first wide receiver to win the Associated Press Player of the Year since that award's inception in 1998. And of course, last year in Bama's national championship win over Ohio State, he was the offensive MVP. 12 receptions, 3 touchdowns, 215 yards, despite leaving early with a hand injury. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the all-time greats from Amite, Louisiana, Devontae Smith.
These past 4 years has been amazing just to come to the University of Alabama and have the opportunity to play for a wonderful university, and without the fans, we wouldn't be able to do this without y'all, and I'm just thankful to have the opportunity. Roll Tide.
Our next honoree is one of the all-time great leaders in Crimson Tide history, another in the list of dominant centers in Alabama history, offensive interior lineman in the nation. He was the winner of the Remington Trophy, presented annually to the nation's top center, and a semifinalist for the Outland Trophy. He was a unanimous first-team All-American. He earned first-team All-SEC honors from both the Associated Press and the conference coaches. He was a co-recipient of the SEC Jacobs Blocking Trophy, along with his teammate, Alex Leatherwood, and the list of honors goes on and on. Ladies and gentlemen, he's a native of Hickory, North Carolina, Landon Dickerson. Yeah!
How many
titles
can
you get?
Roll Tide.
Firstly, I just want to thank Coach Saban, my teammates, and all the fans of Alabama. Y'all welcome me here with open arms, and it's been a tremendous experience for me here. I can't think of a greater honor that I've earned in my life than being voted a team captain. So can't tell you how much my time here has meant to me, and you know, hopefully I can give back to you guys too. Roll Tide.
The next cap captain who we honor excelled in one of the most scrutinized positions in all of college football, the position of quarterback at the University of Alabama. Jalen Hurts, he sat behind Tua, but when his chance came, he took full advantage, leading the Crimson Tide to their 18th national championship. His skills and physical talents allowed him to win the Davey O'Brien Award, the Johnny Unitas Golden Arm Award, the Manning Award. He was named a Consensus All-America and was a finalist for the Heisman Trophy. And as you well know, his statistics last year were as gaudy as could be. 311 completions out of 402 attempts. 7.4% completion percentage. 4,500 yards. 41 touchdowns. He's a native of Jacksonville, Florida. Mac Jones.
Roll Tide.
Right there, but it's an honor to be up here right now. You know, I've been a part of four great teams here, played a lot of different roles, but it's been a dream of mine to be a captain, and a lot of it's, you know, hats off to Coach Saban for giving me a chance, and all my teammates and the great fans of Alabama. It's just really an honor, and it's something I'll never forget. It's great to see everybody that's played here has gotten a chance to be a captain, and it just means a lot to me. So thank you guys, and Roll Tide.
And now, our final honoree of the day. This man was arguably the best left tackle in college football. He anchored an offensive line that won the 2020 Joe Moore Award. He became Alabama's fifth Outland Trophy winner, the fourth since 2008. He was a unanimous first-team All-America, a first-team All-SEC honoree by both the Associated Press and the conference coaches. And he was a co-recipient of the SEC Jacobs Blocking Trophy, along with his teammate Landon Dickerson. Another of our all-time greats, please welcome Alex Leatherwood.
Well, first and foremost, I just want to thank Coach Saban for giving me the opportunity to go here and come to this school. My teammates for holding me to be a captain. And these past 4 years have been the best of my life, honestly. But it's really the fans and all the students here is like truly what made it home. So this will forever be my home in my heart, and I appreciate all y'all. Roll Tide.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about another round of applause for the 2019 and 2020 University of Alabama captains. Now, fellas, if you would make your way towards the tent area right there, there will be some folks who will help you get your footprints, your cleats and handprints in the concrete, and they'll walk you through all that needs to be done. But meanwhile, please welcome to the microphone your head football coach here at the University of Alabama, a man who has the pleasure and the honor of coaching these great athletes, Coach Nick Saban.
Thank you so much. First of all, I'd like to thank all the fans that are here today supporting these young men, our team. I know this has been a little bit of a time where we've all had to go through a lot of disruptions in our life, as well as the way we compete. So this is the first opportunity we've had to have people show their appreciation for these guys as captains and what our teams have been able to accomplish. I think this is one of the greatest traditions that we have at the University of Alabama, because when you are a captain, that means you are somebody that took responsibility to be a leader, which means that you set a good example. You were somebody that somebody could emulate on your team, as well as in the community, and you cared enough about other people to help them for their benefit. Not for your benefit, that's manipulation, for their benefit. And all these young men did a fantastic job on both of our teams the last 2 years of doing just that. And that's what contributed to a lot of winning habits in individuals, that created to a lot of winning habits for a team that was able to accomplish a lot. this last year's team, the 2020 team, to go undefeated in a tournament and win the national championship is something that I'm always going to remember, and it's special in my heart. Each one of these guys are special to me for the role that they played and the success. And you all as fans really make it this the best place to ever be a head coach. And I appreciate all your support and all that you've done to help our teams, and you being a part of our team by the spirit that you create in this program, which make it special for people to come here and go to school and play for you and for this university. So thank you all so much. We appreciate you so much, and Roll Tide.
Here we are in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. You will be seeing the home team of Alabama and the away team of Alabama today. We'll be seeing the scrimmage game as the 8-8 game. Here we are in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Let's see how our team is today for 2021 season of Alabama Crimson Tide. Maybe we can see some good plays by Alabama today. Let's see. All right, guys, while we wait, let's just hop right to
it. Here we go. We did it, coach.
Kickoff is underway. As kickoff is underway, kicks it off. He's gonna return it. He's gonna get it right there. Now here's how we're starting our 8A game. Here's Bryce Young, snaps the ball, runs it in the middle, and it gets bottled up. Here is Bryce Young again. And yeah. See what he can do on the field today. Alright, here we go. Snaps the ball. Looking for somebody. Throws it, and it's caught. Getting closer and closer to the end zone. Thinking this make it a couple more plays. And that was fourth down, I just realized. So now they're looking for a field goal to get in there. And the field goal is good. That will make it 3-0. Here they just returned it and just run it about right there. Here's quarterback. Throws it to number 3. What a great pass by him. Throws it again, and wow, just great passes by Tyson. Here's some more, and he throws it out of bounds. It's incomplete. Here he is again looking for somebody, and he's going to throw it, and he's got it out to him, and he's going to get a couple more yards and hit hard right there. Here's Bryce Young. We'll see what he can do. And goes it. Caught. What a great pass. Here's Bryce Young again, looking for somebody. Oh, he runs it. He just tricked me out. Alright. Here's Bryce Young. Throws it, and he caught it right there. What a great catch by him right there. Bryce Young snaps the ball, looking for somebody, throws it, incomplete. What a great dove. Alright, this is a long field goal. Let's see if they can make this. And no, field goal's no good. Now here's number 17 starting off on his team, see what he can do. Tyson, looking downfield, throws it, caught. Here's Tyson again. Runs the ball up the middle and gets bottled up. Oh, they're still pushing him back. That's going to be no game. Here's Bryce Young again with the ball. Snaps it and throws it and he's caught and it's right there. And here he is again. Throws it, caught right there. See what he can do. Just runs it and he gets bottled up about right there. So if you want to know your score, it is 3-0. Crimson is losing. For right now. Here it is. Snaps the ball, throws it out deep, and it's caught. Oh, and can he run for all the way to the end zone? 10, 5, touchdown! Away team of Alabama. Can you give it up for your away team for Alabama? Because they just scored, and that's going to make it. If they can score, get this extra point, that can make it 10-0. And it is 10-0. Kicks it off back to them. As we see what they can do now onto the field. Here they are looking. Throws it. It's caught by number 17, Alabama. What a great catch by Alabama Crimson. Here they are again. They run it and they're getting closer and closer to the end zone. As they go again, they run it in. They're getting more and more and more yardage as they get closer and closer. Here they go again. Runs it. Oh! Slips it out right there. Bryce Young, let's see what he can do from the back of his end zone. Let's see if he can make some magic plays from here. Runs in the middle and just gets a couple more yardage. Looks at 11. It's caught to get out of the end zone. It's a good yardage. Here's the running back and runs it and he gets bottled up by number 5. Here is Bryce Young. Running it, throws it, and it's incomplete. Here is Bryce Young again, snaps the ball, throws it, caught, and he gets around another tackle, and he's still going on the speed, and he's still going, and he gets tackled back right there out of bounds. Here is Bryce Young again on Alabama. Here we go, see what Alabama can do. But Bryce Young snaps the ball, just throws it, and he gets tackled for no gain. Here's Bryce Young again. Runs the ball, he's getting a lot of yardage. He gets bottled up right there. Here's a long field goal. And it is no good. I knew that one. That one's so far away. See what Bryce Young can do. Not Bryce Young. Crimson. Oh, and that was a great pass by Tyson. Tyson snaps the ball. Goes it. Caught. Wait, incomplete. Here's Tyson again. Throws it out. And he's caught. And he's going to get more yardage out of bounds right there. And here is Bryce Young on the other team. And throws it. Incomplete. Here's a field goal, and it is good. Here is, it's 10-3, if you want to know the original score. Goes it in, it's caught, and it's going to run out of bounds. So if you want to know who is winning, it is Bryce Young right now, leading his team. Oh, what a great catch, and it's hit hard. And yeah. He gets to throw it out, and he's going to get out of bounds about right there. Great yardage by Bryce Young today. And Tyson, just to back up too. Here is Bryce Young with the ball, runs it. And he's going to run out of bounds. As it is now halftime, and now we are heading in to the third quarter. My name is Chance Bailey, and I'm signing off. Now as we are back with some more 8-day game Alabama football. Let's see what we can do. Tyson with the ball to start off the third quarter. Looks, throws it, and just completed. A great pass by number 45. Tyson again throws it to 84, and he's going to get some great yardage. Here's Tyson again, throws it again, and oh, wow! Number 17 is getting some yardage too as this game is going on as a 80 game, and runs it in the middle, and it gets bottled up right there. Here is Tyson again, throws it, and it's caught. Here is Tyson again, and it's running in the middle, and it gets bottled up. Here is again, throws it deep, and what a big hit too. Now here's a field goal from long range. Well, let's see what happens. Kicks it, and it is no good. Alright, here's Tyson, and he's been making some good throws. And, yeah, runs it with the running back, and he runs it up in the middle, and he gets bottled up in the game. Here is the backup, number 19, runs the running back, and so he gets bottled up. And here is Crimson throwing to number 17, and he's going to make some. Here's Bryce Young back out there, throw it, and gets bottled up. Here is number 9, as Bryce Young throws it to him, and he's down. Bryce Young runs the ball, and he's going to get bottled up right there. So look, and he's going to run it out of bounds, or get more, and he's still on his feet. Alright, she throws it, and it is incomplete. Here is the backup number 7. Onto the field for Crimson. Throws it, and it is going to be in. Oh! Picked off by McKinstry! Bryce Young throws it, caught, and by the running back, and he's going to get more yardage. Out of bounds right there. Here he runs it in, jukes it, and he gets down right there. Here is Bryce Young. Snaps the ball, looks out there. He's going to try to throw it, and he did, and it's caught. Bryce Young throws it, caught, out of bounds. Bryce Young is going to snap the ball. Just runs it and throws it, and it is caught. As you see, much time into the game, Bryce Young will have to make a play as quick as possible to win the game. This is a field goal to be winning, and it is good. 13-10 in the fourth quarter. Only a little bit of time left. Looks out deep, throws it out deep, and it's caught. Oh, and number 17's getting a lot of yardage past the yardage that he needed. He got way much. They look like they need to kick a field goal right here to be tying up the game. So they want to win in the 8-day game. Throws it, caught, and it's bottled up. And this is going to be a conclusion of the game. If you want to know who won, it is the away team of Alabama. Crimson lost by number 3 points. This is going to be a conclusion of the game. My name is Chance Bailey. I.